You ready, Anton? Still. Did you guys just watch that? Teach Me Grappling. Khabib Nurmagomedov pulls off a triangle on Justin Gaethje. Insane. What did you think?
I didn't expect it. Not a triangle. That was
You didn't expect it. I don't think Jason Herzog, the referee, expected it either.
He was like, what?
Anyway, hey guys, check this out. If you guys didn't see the fight, we're going to break down the grappling portion of the fight. The striking was insane. It was all over the place. Khabib with some crazy pressure. Unbelievable. It's a crazy fight. Unbelievable. So where are we going to start? Well, Gaethje was doing great with the takedown defense in the beginning, but towards the end of the first round, so much pressure. Khabib used one of his patented, I'm going to fall and run at your legs, kind of takedowns. Yeah. Very good. Just pressure, you know, out of a situation, pressure falling and then catching the double leg. Once he got the double leg, he went for his triangling of the legs, as he does in almost every fight you guys see him in. Once he's here, I'm going to kind of move you away. Yeah.
Why we end up moving off the cage anyway?
And then, so Gaethje's got an overhook. Okay, Gaethje's holding the overhook. And then he gets his butterfly guard back, basically. So as he gets the butterfly guard back, over here on this side, come around, Carlos, over this side. Khabib's got the wrist control. He ends up standing up. The butterflies stay connected, just laying out towards your back. Yep. And he goes into what's called side smash, guys. Side smash is where you walk, and then this knee gets folded like this. Once this knee gets folded, the butterfly hooks are not completely useless, but they're not being used the way they're supposed to be used. So once here, this kind of control, it's really strong. And then out of this position, what happens is he doesn't like to be balled up. So he starts to extend himself. When he starts to extend, this knee can go here, and then the mount happens. Now, once the mount happens, you know, there might have been a little bit of ground and pound, very, very little. Yeah, Gaethje was using his hand like this, trying to block, and then he grabbed on Khabib's head, which then just leads to the S-mount position, the slide up right here. Notice the knee, and then the leg here. Khabib's gonna go for the armbar. He actually made a slight inaccuracy as he went for the leg over here. So as he goes for the leg, slight inaccuracy. Should have leaned forward more to pass the leg over the head, okay? But he fell back and was not able to get the leg over the head. The hands are locked, yep. So he chooses to go over. Now, when you choose to go over with this one, he went all the way over the wrist, which really led this technique to become a bicep slicer. So, or bicep lock, bicep crush. People have different names for it. So with your bone inside here, it's basically a kind of an elbow separation, and it hurts the muscles. It's really painful, but it doesn't really work in MMA at this kind of level. Guys are just not gonna tap to this. One time Gaethje blocked the leg from coming back over the head. And then it really was just a position as time running down for Nurmagomedov to just like do some ground and pound, maybe a hammer fist to the face, couple to the body. If I was to finish this, guys, go ahead, Carlos, get around and just to see different angles. If I was to finish this, which I'm not going to at this level, there's different ways of doing it, but what I would need is to turn and widen the bone so the radius goes here, and then I need to squeeze everything together. And you see that, and I might be able to get one. But you're rarely gonna see guys tap to this. Okay, so it probably wasn't the best situation. What would have been slightly better, just a slightly better thing, would have been to chop over the lock. See that? And even if my leg ends up here, you want the hand to be free and not having the MMA glove stuck behind the knee. If the MMA glove stuck behind the knee, it's hard to separate. In fact, Gaethje might even have liked that it was stuck, because if it was kind of like halfway sticking out, it could get pulled through. And if he's got the leg control, you try to sit up, now it's gonna lead towards a nice arm bar. So it's probably better for Gaethje that it was a bicep lock, and that kind of saved him. All right, in the second round, then we had the second and final takedown. Gaethje was doing really good with some leg kicks, and he threw a couple really good ones. He threw one of the inside, so he went inside, and then the next one came outside, and Nurmagomedov was able to drop and bring his arm and his head to this side. As he was kind of falling in, this leg's gonna be drawn back, and they kind of hit a 180 right here on the two knees, double leg. After that double leg, you see the turn and the rotation. He's coming to the waist to lock his hands, and then Gaethje kind of like, he was gassed from the pressure a little bit, and he just didn't move. He stayed here a little too long, but I gotta give it to Nurmagomedov, had a beautiful transition. Hooks went right in, and at this point, he's making the rotation. As he rotates and turns over, look what's happening. The arm right here, as he's rotating from this under position, comes right into an arm triangle. So the next goal for Khabib is to finish this technique. But because of this, it brought Gaethje's arm out. His right arm comes to the rescue, so up here, and that allowed, as he's freeing this arm, it allowed this position with the knee up. Now, this arm is locked into a position over here where it's kind of trapped. It's not in a defensive position. It's not in a defensive position here where he can start to bump and move and everything will work a lot better for him. When it kind of gets caught out here with a head control like this, it's kind of stuck. And then now, this part, just turn. Yeah, just turn the angle. Okay, now this hand, this right here, you see Khabib going for the wrist. He's already thinking triangle. So it's not like there was like multiple moves. It was pretty simple. This guy's elbows are out. He's just gonna grab onto the wrist. If I push it like this, he doesn't want me to do this, because if I push it out, I might shoot my leg through this window. You see that? So what happens is when you do this kind of motion, the guy always pulls his elbow in. They try to pull their elbow in, he just went around. You see that? So you have two ways to do this triangle. One is to open and shoot over the biceps and then shoot it through. But because that's not gonna work, the guy closed the elbow in, you just chop over. And then with the MMA gloves, this hand is kind of stuck. See that? At this point, Khabib's pulling up on the neck, and you know, Gaethje's in serious danger, but it's not that bad yet completely. I mean, it's bad, but he's still got some chances to bump and move out of here. But what really made this move work, because if Khabib tries to fall back, Gaethje can kind of stay where you are, right? Mm-hmm. Like, don't come on top of me. See that? Lean back, like almost bridge. Yeah, like that. But then watch this. He went here. This right here, bringing that toe up. See the angles? Come around here, look at this. The toe here with the knee here. This locks this arm. So now, it's not just the simple triangle. So everybody goes, oh, he just got him in a triangle. It's not the simple triangle, it's this threat. The moment that Anton right here, who's Gaethje, feels the squeeze, you feel you have to, huh? As he comes up, okay? See, he has to come up. The lock comes, okay? The lock comes. And then again, he gets all the way up. As he goes all the way up, the lock goes completely in like this. I'm sorry about that. I'm trying to not choke him out. Okay, so guys, once I'm here, I'm just gonna make it without choking him. Then what happens? He gets lifted with a really short slam, but the underhook in the leg, that made the slam very small for Nurmagomedov, didn't hurt him at all. And then now the finish is here. He might've been grabbing his toe right here and squeezing. And then nobody saw it except for everyone watching.
Everyone except for the ref.
Everybody except
this guy's like, please. He even fell to the side, I think, eventually.
Yeah.
He was like,
yeah, well, yeah.
He's going out. He's like,
he went out, but they finally did it, and he's unconscious. Poor Jason, the ref.
Such a good guy.
Jason's a good guy. He's a good guy. He messed up. I'm sure he regrets it. He's feeling like a complete bonehead for fouling that up. But anyway, pretty exciting fight. I mean, there's so much magnitude to see, like, these two guys go at it. And I mean, anytime, you know, Nurmagomedov fights, it's a huge fight. So, but I was really excited to watch, and it was fun to see a guy at least defend the takedown for
one time
for, you know, for 4 minutes and then get taken down at the end of the first. It was an exciting fight because you never know what could have happened. But either way, the pressure of Khabib was insane. Crazy pressure. So
he doesn't care. He just keeps going forward. Yeah.
So, guys, like I always do on these types of breakdowns, I try to show you guys where maybe it wouldn't have went so wrong. You know, as far for Gaethje, from Gaethje's point of view, what could he have done better? Because the obvious winner is Nurmagomedov. Everyone gives me a lot of hate because they always think I'm trying to say that Nurmagomedov's not great, which, guys, I said before this fight, if he wins this fight, he's the greatest of all time. I really believe that, and I think he deserves that title right now. There's other fighters, there's other great fighters, but in my eyes, he's the greatest of all time. So guys, anybody haters out there on because I'm teaching you guys technique, understand that I'm breaking down technique. He's the greatest of all time, in my opinion. Now, what could Gaethje have done? There was the first takedown. Let's talk about the side smash real quick. So if you do a double leg and I fall down, right? And guys, he wraps up the ankles. Remember with this one? Yeah. And he's here. Once the butterfly guard got in and I'm here, look, Gaethje has an overhook. Move around, Carlos, so you can see these angles. Look, he has an overhook. And then you have my wrist. See that? So if you guys are playing right here and you start to stand up and then now starting to walk, this is bad. This is bad. So guys, look, the moment is here, I'm not gonna hold the overhook because now you just close distance. You know, like drop your this down. I'm gonna get beat up now. You guys see that? I'm gonna get mounted. So go ahead and stand back up where you were. Like, it's about to be side smash. You're putting the knee through, right? Look, loop, just let go of the overhook. Don't do that, post. Start creating space. This is what you have to do, guys. Now, does that mean I'm safe and I'm gonna win? No, it doesn't mean that. He's gonna throw bombs. But I'm gonna be trying to make moves and get out of this position. I gotta grapple. I can't just hold on. And that's what Gaethje did way too much. He was a little tired. He was tired. You know, people were talking about how much he was breathing. He was tired. But he also, the fight had just started, you know? Conor McGregor didn't get his guard passed that fast. He really needed some guard fundamentals, which he did not have. After that, holding on to the neck in the mount, this is gonna get you armbarred. You go to the mount, and like, guys, look, if I hold on like this, he's just gonna slide the knee up, and he's in, like, he's gonna armbar me. So you can't do this. So the alternative in some people's minds are gonna be like, well, he's gonna hit you, so you have to hold his neck. But if I hold his neck, he's gonna armbar me, right? So if you start to go to S mount and I let go and I start moving, you're gonna hit me, right? You know, I'm gonna shrimp and hip escape and try to get back. We're gonna be in a fight right now. You know, I'm not gonna just sit there and just hold on. I mean, that was really bad. He survived the round, so that was good.
That was the first, right?
Yeah, end of the first. Excellent. Now the second one, the second takedown. So now. You're gonna catch my kick, right? So I go here, he comes in as he hits here, and then that little court, that turn, he could have chosen to sit here, guys. This is the jiu-jitsu answer. And I know a lot of people will say, oh, he's a wrestler, he's not gonna just go to his back. But look what happened. Like now I can actually like do things. I'm not saying I'm gonna sweep Nurmagomedov, but I can fight from here. The think about what he did. He gave his back. He just gave it. Then, yeah, you're on my back. Then just lock your hands. Then as he turned over, watch this. I'm turning, he turned into the arm triangle. You guys see how that's gonna work? So if I'm like this and you're locked, when I turn over, guys, watch how I turn over. My elbows come in and I go to arm triangle. You see that? See my arm coming in? Now look, hand control, and I have this hand. I'm hip escaping, and I'm working my way back. I don't just let the guy, I don't let him, you know, I don't let him just, oh, here's my arm, put my arm up here. That's just a big mistake, okay? Then, I'm like this, so now, this caused this. So as I'm trying to get out, now he can slide the left knee up. You guys see how that happened? So it's like one thing after another. He's coming at him with multiple attacks. Keep moving around, Carlos. Just get some angles. So now when I'm here, guys, look, this arm is bad. It's bad. This hand now is the focus of attack for Anton right now. He's gonna be trying, look at, if he pins that down, he's gonna get a triangle, right? So we discussed that. So what was the natural defense? Was to do this. Now, even right here, guys, don't let this heel, don't let it go into your neck. So like, go back and do that one more time. Look at this little movement, go. See how I have a sticky here?
Yeah.
Now you see how I move it out? Now, when it chops, let's say I mess up, and he, bam, he has like real precise, and he catches it. Now, guys, look, the left hand was on the head at first, pulling. Now, guys, look, the next thing I need to do is the powers in my hips. The powers in my hips. I load my toes, and then go towards the front so you can see the front. So, as he's trying to pull the triangle and make the triangle, I'm gonna put my body back like this. See how I put all that weight there? Can you hold that?
Mm-hmm.
Guys, Anton, I'm like 150. Anton's like 95.
Oh, thank you. Finally.
He used to be 200, but he's down to 95. Okay, 195. So he's pulling. Pull hard. Pull. You get used to hands. Ready? Keep going. You see that? Like, but does he do that? No. So there's ways to still salvage this bad position. He has to really lean back if you're gonna hold me. You're pulling the head, right? And then, but then I will admit, once that leg steps up, oh man, now you don't even need the head. Because if I bridge now, I break my own arm. Like if I go like this and you lean back, you see that? You're gonna tap me. So guys, look, this is getting really bad. Now you start squeezing your thighs, falling back. I'm gonna start coming up because I have to. Now, once I come up, guys, look, don't turn into the triangle. You're getting excited, Gaethje. He gets excited, he turns in and gives the triangle and gives the angle. Doesn't just give the triangle, but gives the angle. Open and close this real quick. Like just relax it and open and, yeah, right there. Now, he has a leg and I'm done. But when I come up like this, guys, it's not locked yet. I don't want to turn into it. I want to keep this angle like this. Now choke me. Wrap the triangle.
That's as tight as
yes, but now you have the floor in the way. Can you armbar? Close your knees tight. Yeah, keep going. I'm still staying sideways.
I think I'd go over at that point.
You want to go omoplata,
yeah,
right? I would much rather have an omoplata than have a triangle like this. Okay, so when he came up, he literally just turned right into the deepest triangle. Is this armbar possible? Yes, it is possible, guys. Good guy, you can learn how to manipulate, but it, you see how you gotta try to make that work?
Yeah.
You see that? Now I'm coming up, I'm going, doing some, this is some Gary Tonin, Cron Gracie armbar defense kind of stuff, but you're arching up, arching up, arching up, arching up, I roll. I'm not gonna go in that triangle, guys. I want the omoplata. I will please take the omoplata. Because when he goes to the shoulder lock, now I'm like, all right, we can now, you know, get out of here, maybe hit a car with something like that. Even if I get taken to the bottom, at least I don't get triangled or armbar. So, what am I saying? Am I saying that Gaethje should have won? No, he lost. What I'm showing you guys is when you have two great fighters and they fight, just because they're the best in the world doesn't mean there's not inaccuracies. There are people who analyze chess, and when they see the best guys play chess, of course, during the match, they're in these moments. They have to make their best play. But they always make mistakes. You can do this with Olympic athletes in wrestling, judo. You can see where they went wrong. And why do that? So that you can learn and get better. So.
Good stuff.
You got anything to add?
No, I think that's a lot. We did that was the whole thing, man.
Just talk to him.
Talk to him. You gotta click that thumb, that like. We're gonna help you guys with that. I know it's hard. Clicking the like, the subscribe. We got cool hats that we're making. other stuff. Is this for me? Да? Понятно? Давайте идите все на membership, все через Patreon, и мы будем вместе лучше.
If you don't sign up on our membership, I will smash you. Okay? All right.
Да.
That's all I have.
Good.
Guys, thank you guys so much. Congratulations to Khabib Nurmagomedov. In my opinion, greatest fighter of all time in the UFC. Actually, of all time, that's what I'm saying.
I'm
giving him that title.
Yeah.
Guys, if you guys want to argue with me, just comment down below and I'll try to argue back.
Argue time.
All right? I love you guys. Thank you guys so much. Also, congratulations to Justin Gaethje on just an amazing performance. He needs to obviously improve, but man, he went out there and he showed his stuff. And he's also a very good person, so hats off to both of them. All right? That's it. See you guys next time. More great stuff.